my side and let me share the screen. One minute, please. Vishnu. Yeah, Vishnu, you can record the session. Just click on record button. That's it. Okay. And I see Cherry, Gautam, Bhima. You are joined from phone. Jay Chandra. Okay. You're recording. Parameshwar Reddy. Okay. You joined from phone. Priya. Rajshekhar, most of you people are joined from phone, right? Sainath, phone. Snehita Reddy, phone. Venkat, phone. Okay, that's fine. Okay, let me share my screen. I told you, right, every 40 minutes the meeting is going to close automatically. So immediately join with the same link. Just click on the same link. It won't ask passcode and all. Immediately join with the same link to join. Okay. Right. Yes, let me. Yes, thank you so much for muting. All right. So as a DBA, we are responsible for installing the SQL servers. Okay. It is our responsibility to install the SQL servers and all. Next, after installing the SQL servers, what we can do, okay, we have to like give the permissions. Right, this is a database. Critical data is going to be stored in the database. Okay, critical data is going to be stored in the database. A sensitive data will be stored in the database. So we cannot allow everyone to access the database. We cannot give permissions to read the data from the database to everyone. In the organization, whatever we are doing, we should have some requests. Okay, we cannot do it our own. We have to get an email from the customer, or we have to get an email from the user. Remember one thing, I'm going to use some terminologies like customer. Customer means the client. User means those who are using the database. Users, customers, business owners, everyone is same. For them only we are working actually. That is their project. We are working for their project. Okay, users are customers are particular, I can say sometimes I can use stakeholders, users, customers, stakeholders, business owners, clients, all are same only. Okay, in the organization, we are going to use these words, we are going to hear these words from the people. So don't worry what is meant by user, what is meant by stakeholder, what is meant by business owner. Business owners are stakeholders are users. Okay, all are clients only. Means those who gave the project to us. We can call them as client. Those who gave the project to us, we can call them as client. Okay, right. So for them, we have to give access. Okay, so it depends upon the requirement. Everyone will have same kind of access, may have same kind of access, may not have same kind of access. Some people will have only read access. Some people will have read write access. Okay, so it depends upon the particular person. Permissions and authorization. Okay, it depends upon the respective person's requirements. So it is going to change. You may have read write permissions. The other user may have only read permissions. The other user may have sysadmin permissions. Depends upon their work, the permissions is also going to change. Okay, just 1 minute. Right, so depends upon the yes. When Geetanjali, I cannot hear you. Okay, can you hear me? You can hear me, right? This is not audible. Just 1 minute, please. Yeah, Geetanjali, can you hear me? Yeah, Geetanjali, just join from phone. Yeah, can you hear me? Yeah, Gitanjali, can you hear me? In case if you're facing issues, okay, just join from phone. Right, okay, fine. So Geetanjali, can you hear me now? Use computer audio or join audio. Yeah, Geetanjali, can you hear me now?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so as a SQL DBAs, what we have to do, we have to give the permissions to the users. Okay, we have to create the login for them. And depends upon their requirements, we can give read permissions, write permissions. Okay, you are not the decision maker. Okay, you are not the decision maker. What kind of permissions you have to give? Don't worry at all. They will have the requirement. Okay, once they have the requirement, they are going to raise a request using some ticketing tools. Okay, in the organization, we'll have ticketing tools to request any requirement. 1 minute, please. Okay, in the organization, we'll have ticketing tools. Okay, usually we have ticketing tools like ServiceNow is one kind of ticketing tool, Jira is one kind of ticketing tool, Lotus Notes is one kind of ticketing tool, Remedy is one kind of ticketing tool. Okay, so depends upon the company, the ticketing tools are going to be different. Ticketing tool means simply it's also an application. If users having any requirements, they are going to raise a request using this ticketing tool. It's not like they will come to, in case someone is asking, seeking for permissions. Okay, they won't come to your desk, hey Sai, please give the read permissions to me. They won't come and they cannot ask directly like that. Everything should have proofs. Later, okay, if he says, no, I didn't ask any permissions, he only gave the permissions, what is the proof? So that's why usually for any requirement in the organization, they are going to raise the tickets. So for example, if something happened, okay, you will call to customer care and your internet is not working. You will call to customer care. They are going to assign you one ticket number. That is the requirement. That is the issue. Okay, by using the ticket number, they are going to track the status of your requirement. Right? So in the organization, we'll have tickets for each and every requirement. We will discuss what is meant by ticket, what is meant by ticketing tool, what are change requests, what kind of change requests we need. Okay. Of course, I cannot show you the service now and all, but I'll explain everything, the ITIL process. Okay, we'll discuss the ticketing tools as well. Okay, so once you got any request from the customer, you have to give the permissions, you have to create login for them, you have to give access on the database to them. So it's our responsibility at the end of the day, again, it's our responsibility to provide the permissions to the users as well. Okay, and yes, taking backup, something happened to the database. Don't know, suddenly the database is down, suddenly the server is down, or suddenly the server is crashed, or suddenly the database is corrupted, then how you are going to recover the data? I told you, right, lot of sensitive information is going to be stored in the database, lot of secured information, okay, lot of what we can say very useful information is going to stored in the database. Okay, in case if something happened, how you are going to recover the data? It's very natural the database can be corrupted. It's very natural the server may be crashed. In case of any issues, how you are going to recover the data? So that's why we are going to take the backups on each and every database regularly. On each and every database, we'll take the backups. Okay. What happened? I see three people left. Can you hear me? Any issues, any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, So it is our responsibility. So what we are going to do is we are going to take the backups of each database and we are going to restore whenever the database is corrupted. Okay, whenever in the difficult situation, what we can do is we are going to restore the databases. So if we have to restore the databases, first of all, okay, we have to take the backup, right? In case, right, suddenly your phone is corrupted or like your phone is crashed. Okay, what you are going to do? Again, you are going to buy a new phone. Okay, once you bought a new phone, what you will do, you are going to register with the email account, the same email account which you gave in the last mobile. You are going to register with that email account. So as you just turned on the synchronization options in the phone, all the contacts and photos will be saved to your Google Drive. If you gave the same email ID to register new device, once you just registered in the new device, automatically you are going to get all the data. How it is possible? The data, the particular device is maintaining, the particular account, Google account is maintaining a backup of your data. Once you just restore your particular device, or once you just register in a new device with the same email ID, whatever data that is there in your email ID, that is going to be, okay, full inside your new device. That is how the synchronization and all will work. Okay, that is called a backup. You can see every day at 2 a.m., WhatsApp is going to take the backup of your chart. If you see, every day at 2 a.m., WhatsApp will take the backup. In case if it's not taking backup at 2 a.m., early morning, once you open the WhatsApp, it will show backup. Okay, every day the WhatsApp will take the backup of your messages. In case if something happened to your WhatsApp, or else if you reinstall the WhatsApp in the same device or another device, you are going to get all the charts. How it is possible? WhatsApp will keep on taking the backup of your messages. So that's why you can see. So backup is very important. In case of anything happened, you can easily retrieve the data using the backup copies. Okay, so that's how it is going to work. Okay, so as a DBA, we are the responsible one to create the, to take the backups and restore the database in case of any issues happen. Okay, database refresh task. We are going to do database refresh task regularly in the organization. What is this database refresh tasks? Actually, the data will have different environments in the organization. Okay, we'll have production environment, non-production environment. Okay, environments. Sometimes in the interview, they will ask, okay, what are the environments you worked? Okay, we will have 4 or 5 environments. Production environment, prod means production. Dev means developer. Okay, and stays. QA, UAT, test. These are the different environments in the organization. UAT, test, both are same. QA environment, stage environment, dev environment. These are all non-prod. Okay? Prod and non-prod will have two different environments in the organization. Production environment and non-production environment. Production is very important for us. Okay? Actual live application is going to run on production environment only. Right? Live application is going to run on production environment only. If something happened to the production database, that's it, your application will be down. Non-prod, just for testing purpose. Okay, non-prod, just for testing purpose. In case you want to test your logic, the developers wants to test their logic, and you want to test some features, you cannot test on the production, right? If something happened to the production, your application will be impacted. So we will have non-prod environment. Whatever we want to do, the developers wants to test their logics and all, they are going to test on the non-prod environment. Once it is successful, they are going to implement on the production environment. Okay, so we will have production environment and non-prod environment. Production environment, usually the live application is going to run. The live application will be mapped to the production environment. In case if your production database is down, your application also will be down. Imagine if WhatsApp is not working for 1 minute, how many users are going to be impacted? Throughout the globe, 200 crore users are going to be impacted. More than 200 crore users, more than 200 crore users are using WhatsApp. Okay, in 700 crore population throughout the globe, okay, 200 plus crore users are using the WhatsApp. Imagine if WhatsApp is down for 1 minute, how many users are going to be impacted? If SBI net banking is not working for 1 minute, how many users are going to be impacted? If Amazon.in is not going to work for 1 minute, how many users are going to be impacted? A very huge loss will come for Amazon. Very huge loss will come. Okay, so that's why customers won't allow for the downtime of the application. That should be run. The application should run for 24/7/365 days. The production is very important. Okay, the live application is very important. If it is down for 1 second also, they are going to lose millions of dollars, crores of rupees. So that's why they don't allow us for the downtime even for 1 second also. Okay, so that's why we are very careful with the production environment. Okay, non-prod, I told you, right? Whatever logics you want to do, you can do on your non-prod. Whatever like testing and all you want to do, you can do it on non-prod environment. Okay, these are the terminologies. Non-prod means dev stage. Sometimes in the interviews they will ask, even though you keep 5 years of experience, they will ask what environments. Last week my student experienced one question. He just completely very happy with the interview. Okay, the interviewer is very satisfied with the candidate. Finally, he asked one question: on what environments you are going to work daily? You don't know what environments are there. What to answer? He don't know what to answer. He lose his job. Just very basic question, very very basic question. So we cannot expect what kind of questions you are going to get from the interviewer. Okay, so very important. Anything is very important. Don't know why, because today they are going to get, they are getting lot of doubts whether this candidate is real or fake, right? So to test their knowledge, they are going to ask these kind of silly questions also. Yes, it is a silly question, but if you don't know it, it's a very big question, right? So very, whatever we are discussing, every point is an important point. Every point is an interview point also. Okay, right? So we have different environments, like production and non-prod environment. In the non-prod, we'll have dev, test, stage, QA, UAT. These kind of environments will be there. Okay, so you have to be very careful about these terminologies also, right? So developers wants to test their logic in the non-prod environment, right? So but non-prod environment doesn't have any data, live data. Why? Because application will be connected to the production environment, but non-prod environment doesn't have any live data. Then how can they test their logic on the live data? So as a DBAs, we have to take the backup of the production environment database and we have to restore it into the non-prod so that they can get the live data and they can test their logics. This is called database refresh activities. Very regularly, weekly, monthly, sometimes daily, okay, we have to do these activities, database refresh tasks. Refreshing means just you are going to take the backup of production database and you are going to restore it into the non-prod environment is called database refresh task. In case of backup failures, in case of restore failures, as a DBA, it is our responsibility to take care of those failures as well. Okay, right. As of now, is it clear or any issues? Please let me know. No problem. You can stop me and you can ask me the questions. Okay, don't worry. I'm in a group. Maybe this is a silly question, nothing like that. If you don't know anything, even though if you don't know what is my computer, ask me. You are learning. Okay, don't feel shy in learning the things. In case if you feel shy, you are the big loser. If you don't know, ask. Nothing to worry. Don't think others know. Maybe they also don't know. Don't feel shy in a group. Okay, you have to be act as a professional from today onwards. If you don't know, ask me. No problem at all. There is no silly question, simple question, small question, big question. Question is question only. Okay, in case if you have any questions, just let me know. Is it clear, everyone? Till now, is it clear? Yes, okay. Yes. Yeah,
clear, sir.
Okay, good. Fine, right? And creating and scheduling jobs. Jobs means, say for example, I am having 1,000 servers. Each server is having 10 databases. 1,000 server into 10, 10,000 databases are there. Is it possible to take manual backup on 10,000 databases daily? Not possible. 10,000 for logging to the 10,000 server itself, 10,000 servers itself, it will take 1 or 10 days or 20 days. Why? Because lot of servers are there. If you want to log into manually, it will take lot of time. Then how you can take backup of manual databases for each database for 10,000 databases. Very difficult thing, right? So we have automation in the SQL Server. We can automate using jobs. You can create a backup job which will run on every server, which will take the backup of all the databases automatically. Okay, for that, what you have to do? You have to create the jobs. Job means simply an automation. Okay, a task that can be completed in a specific time. A query will be there. That query will run, say, for example, now I want to take backup on all the databases today night at 2 a.m. Again, today night at 2 a.m., I have to wake up and I have to turn on my laptop and I have to log into the server. I have to take the backups. No, it is not going to work like that. We'll simply have one query. That query will be scheduled at 2 a.m. Okay, once it was scheduled, like alarm, if you put alarm for morning 5 o'clock, automatically you are going to get a ring, right? In the same way, that query is going to run at 2 a.m. Automatically, it is going to take the backups of all the databases. That is called automation. That can be achieved using the jobs and maintenance plans. Okay, so as a DBA, we are going to create the jobs and we are going to, create the maintenance plans, and we are going to schedule the jobs as well. So we are going to discuss how to do that and how to create the jobs, how to create maintenance plans and all. Okay, next, configuring high availabilities. What is this high availability? Where we are going to use the high availability? Okay, what is the usage of the high availability? Imagine high availability means simply only one thing: highly available. Okay, highly available. High availability means highly available. The application should be highly available. I told you, right? Customer won't agree even though his application is down for 1 second also. Then how you are going to manage the maintenance work and all? Every server will have some maintenance work. Every year, every month, server will have some maintenance work, right? In case of maintenance work, you have to shut down the server. How you are going to maintain the maintenance? It will be difficult thing, right? If he is not at all agree to down the server for a minute or for a second, it will be very difficult, right? So we will have high availability, okay, features in the SQL Server. Highly available, the application should be highly available. How can we achieve this? We can achieve it using, okay, five features like log shipping. Okay, you can see here, right? Log shipping, okay, mirroring. These are the features of the SQL Server: mirroring, replication, clustering. In clustering, we have Windows clustering, okay, and SQL Server clustering, SSFC, SQL Server failover cluster, and we have always on as well. Okay, these are some of the HADR options: high availability, disaster recovery. HA means high availability, DR means disaster recovery. Simply, we will have secondary server, okay, for all the primary servers. We will have secondary servers, like in the old movies you see twins, okay, heroes are twins. If something happened to one hero, the another hero will come into the play and he is going to act as the main hero. In the same way, we will have two servers in the application. If something happened to the primary server, immediately we are going to fail over the application to the secondary server. So the application will be, okay, the downtime will be very less for the application. So the customer won't feel, okay, that the application is down. Okay, this is how it will work. So as a DBA, we have to configure and we have to maintain and we have to troubleshoot for all these HADR options. Okay, we can call them as HADR options. Just 1 minute, please. Lot of nonsense. Noise is there from my side. Just 1 minute. Right. Okay. So that's why what we have to do, we have to configure high availability disaster recovery solutions for each of the particular critical applications. See, in the organization, we are going to manage a lot of applications. Applications means don't think WhatsApp is only application, Facebook is only application, Amazon is only application, or Flipkart, or SBI banking, net banking, HDFC net banking. Don't think only these are the applications. These are the external applications. We have two types of applications: external application and internal application. Okay, External and internal. Okay, external apps means public, those the applications used by public, like your Amazon.in, Flipkart, WhatsApp, IRCTC. Okay, the applications that are used by public is called an external application. Internal applications means say for example you go for HDFC bank or else you go for SBI bank. Once you go to SBI bank, you want to deposit some money, some 10,000 rupees you want to deposit in your account. Once you go to your SBI bank, okay, they will ask your account number. You have to fill the form. Okay, in that form you can see you have to enter your account number and the particular details as well, how much money you are going to. Once you just give the cash and the account form, that form to the cashier, he is going to open his application. He will type your account number. You are going to get the details that will be used for internal purpose. That is not accessed by the public, right? The application that are using inside the bank, that is an internal application. Got it? If something happened to the application, the cashier cannot get your details and he cannot add money into your account, or he cannot debit money from your account. So what happened? The business will be down. Right, the users will wait till the issue is going to be resolved. So application that are used internally is called an internal application. Application that are used for public is called an external applications. Every application, internal or external, every application will have a database. Okay, every application will have a database. Right, so in case if something happened to my database, one more secondary server will be there. It is going to take care of the data, it is going to take care of the application and all. So as a DBA, we are responsible to configure the HADR options like log shipping, mirroring, replication, clustering, and always on. Very important features. Okay, right? And yes, not this one. Right, DBA activities, right? And of course, fixing and troubleshooting the issues, we are the responsible, the DBA is the responsible one for fixing and troubleshooting the issues. And if something happened to the SQL server, we have to tune the SQL server. Sometimes you will get a request like, hey, my application is running slow. Hey, my query is running slow. Okay, I'm unable to pull the data, but the query is taking a lot of time to run or to run on specific database. This kind of request you'll get means performance is not good. Sometimes if you see, if you just click on any product, it is keep on rotating, buffering. It is keep on buffering or rotating if you see. Okay, means it is unable to pull the data in a timely manner. Okay, so that is called performance issues. Okay, if you see here, if you see my laptop, okay, if you go to the task manager, you can see the memory usage, CPU usage of my laptop. Currently, CPU usage is around 66 to 90%. Okay, sometimes it will come down, sometimes it will go up. If my CPU usage went to 100%, if it is keep on hitting 100%, my laptop will be hanged. I cannot access my laptop. In the same way, if memory is also hitting 100%, memory usage is also hitting 100%, I cannot use my laptop or I cannot use my server. Means some of the applications are consuming a lot of memory and CPU. In such case, what happened? Your database performance will be degraded. As a DBAs, we have to check what is exactly happening, which applications are taking a lot of CPU and memory. Okay, based on that, we have to start troubleshooting of the particular issue. That is called tuning the SQL server. As a DBAs, we are the responsible to tune the SQL server and all. These are the common activities in the organization. Okay, once you go to the company, once you go to the office regularly, you will have your Outlook. You just open the Outlook, you will get some mails. If any jobs are failed, you will get mails. If any issues are there, you will get mails. If any tickets are raised, you will get mails. Okay, simply you have to open each mail and you have to read the mail completely and you have to troubleshoot the issue accordingly. These are the daily regular activities. Apart from that, a lot of activities are there, but very common activities are. These are the very common activities. Okay, and sometimes customers will give you some scripts. Hey, please execute this script on the database. So again, okay, we have to ask them to raise a change request for that. Once the change is approved, then we can able to run the scripts on the databases and all. This is how it follows. Okay, these are the common activities in the organization. Any questions, any doubts till now, please?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, that's fine. Right, fine. Yes. Let me go with the course. Okay, SQL preparation. Yes. Duties and activities also we have completed, right? Course duration, again, the meeting is going to close in 1 minute, 45 seconds. If the meeting is closed automatically, please use the same meeting link to join, okay? Every 40 minutes, the meeting is going to close. Please use the same link to join in the meeting. Right, course duration, usually we are going to discuss, I told you, right? Usually we are going to discuss a lot of things. Every topic, we are going to discuss the theory part. We are going to discuss the demo part. We are going to discuss the issues on that particular topic and interview questions and some assignments. So every topic we are going to touch five corners. Every topic will touch the five corners. So usually it will take a lot of time when compared to other trainers. Yes, other trainers are completing in 30 hours, but believe me, 30 hours, you cannot learn anything. Again, I'm telling you, you don't have chance to learn the technology every time. You don't have money, you don't have time every time, right? Once you got a chance to learn, learn completely. Okay, that is our goal. Once you got a chance to learn, learn completely. Why you have to learn incompletely by paying that much of money? Okay, so that's why the course duration is high when compared to other trainers. Why? Because we are going to discuss a lot of things for each and every topic. Okay, it will be usually 2 to 2.5 months. Course duration will be usually 2 to 2.5 months. Okay, the meeting is going to close now. Again, please join with the same meeting link. Okay, the course duration is usually 2 to 2.5 months. So if we start by this weekend, okay, it is going to be end by July ending. Okay, the course is going to be end by July ending. Okay, June and July, 2 months we have, right? So, and July ending, by July ending, we are going to complete the course by July.